Hi, hello everyone.
Hello.
I'm sorry for the glitch, but we are now back. Hello, Alicia. Hello, Pradeepa. And Hitomi.
Hi.
Hello. And we have a new student. And here's Simon. Okay. Now, before I forget, I start by sharing my screen. Okay, Yagita, hello. Is that Yagita? Hi, Simon.
Hi.
All right. So we're going to start with reading again. But now let's just get started with summarizing text. So today, for those two new students or three new students, I'm gonna show you how to do summarizing text. We have a template for that, all right? If you like, I can send the template through the chat. Otherwise, I open the template and you can take a photo of it for now. Please have your cameras ready and take a photo of this. Smile, cheese. Okay, there you go.
Excuse me here.
Yes, you tell me.
Is it important to use the template for summarized written text? Because what I used to do is just find two sentences from the...
Don't. He told me don't. Yeah. I know what you're going to say. Don't. I had a student. He was very good in writing. Mm. And I asked him to forget about his own writing and follow my templates. And once he finished his exam, I asked him whether he honestly, because I knew he was very good in writing. I knew his writing. So I asked him, really, tell me, what did you do? Did you follow my? He said, I followed both of them. Okay. Mm-hmm. And he got 90 for his speaking and for his, in fact, he got 90 across. So that was 4 years ago. And that was the time that I stopped using the whatever you were saying, stop using that. Everyone should use this one, okay?
Yeah.
And I know this works, so don't worry, just use it because yes, the main problem. I'm gonna, when I play the video for you for the second time, you will understand more. The main reason is that a lot of students make stupid mistake, grammatical mistakes here and there. And that's why the computer is very good at grammar. Remember, the computer is very good at grammar, horrible at understanding the meaning of words. So there we go. Okay. So did you take a photo, everyone? Yes. Yagita, is that, am I pronouncing it correct? Hello. Hello, I can't hear you. I think,
it's Yagita.
Yep. Yagita. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
It's good to see you. Have you done the test before?
No, this is my first day.
All right. that's good you have your kids with you. It's good. Okay, let's get started.
My dad.
So, did you take a photo?
Yep, I did.
Okay, so we're going to start. Now, I'm going to play you a video and that shows you how to do how to use this template in your, I haven't prepared my stuff. Sorry about that. My computer is a clutter. Okay. Writing, summarize, written text. There we go. Okay. So that's an intro, forget about that. I'll start with this one. Okay, let's go. After each video, I stop it. If you have any questions, to ask and then to carry on.
So first of all, what is a summarized written text? The PTE writing module consists of two parts, summarized written text and essay writing, respectively. PTE candidates will have one or two summarized written text questions in their PTE test. In the summarized written text, you will be given 10 minutes to summarize a text, sometimes up to 250 words, into one sentence. This one sentence can be as short as 5 and as long as 75 words. You can have a certain number of punctuation marks, but only one full stop at the end of your sentence. How is summarized written text scored? The first and the most important condition is to have one sentence that is grammatically okay. Once this condition is met, the computer goes one step further and scores your content. So if, for example, by mistake, you type a full stop instead of a comma in your one sentence response, then because your sentence has not met the first condition, which is one sentence with one full stop, you will lose most of the points for that question. So pay close attention to your punctuation and read your response 2 or 3 times before you submit it. To give you an idea of how an actual summarized written text is scored in terms of its content, let's do one summarized written text together. So you just do the reading part and I will summarize it into one sentence without using my template, of course.
So
I will give you 4 minutes to read this real summarized written text passage.
Yeah, please read it.
Please read it because it is very important in understanding the scoring system and how you should choose your content for the template later.
Who is this guy? I'm talking and he's talking over my voice. Come on. Yes, please read it because it is important to understand how the markings and which words you're supposed to choose, okay? So the time starts now.
So the whole passage, as you noticed, was about how cocoa beans were used by the Aztec and the Maya people in six major ways. And the most important condition, of course, is to compose one sentence that has most of the important content words in it. And this means that you should be very good at grammar to accommodate all those different sentences containing the content words. So when you are choosing content words, do not use a synonym for any of the content words of the text. Just use the actual words from the text. Because the test developers have to give a list of the important content words that they think is at the heart of the passage. This list does not have any synonyms or antonyms of the content words used in the text. It only has the main content words. So for instance, for this passage, the content words list may look like this. Once your sentence has passed the one sentence condition, it is time to compare how similar your summary is to the content list saved on the computer as the answer for that test item. And if the similarity is above 30%, you will get the full mark for that summarizes in text question. And below that threshold, we'll get a relative score to its lack of similarity. In this case, the similarity between the number of the content words list and my one sentence summary is 26 to 58, which makes it around 44% similar to the content words list. And that is exactly why I want you to use my template, because I know how the marking system works in the PTE test. I have also devised a set of 10 PTE mock tests.
Any questions up to here? So I haven't even started the teaching the template. So that was all about how the marking system works. Okay, any questions? No? Okay, let's get started with the template. A few more about, yes, how it is scored. I think we did this one. Check.
How is summarized written text scored?
Okay, so number three, do's and don'ts.
Some do's and don'ts of summarized written text. First, we'll start with some do's. Number one, if you have a laptop, make sure you practice typing on a wired or wireless keyboard. It is important that you practice and learn to type under exam conditions. Some of my students who practiced on their laptops complained after their exam that it was difficult for them to type on a desktop keyboard as they had gotten used to typing on their laptops. Number two. Once you memorized the template, practice writing summarizes in text under exam conditions by timing yourself. You can also practice on my website at thept.com, where everything is very similar to the real PT exam. Number three, learn the rules of typing and punctuation. Look at the following example. How many mistakes can you find in this summarized written text answer?
One, two, three. Or five mistakes.
first word of a... Take number one. You start the first letter of the first word of a complete sentence with a capital letter. So black should be in a capital letter here. And of course, there's a problem of spelling there as well. Number two. You are copying from a text in front of you. So you should not have any typos in your response. Double check your spellings with the original text in front of you. Number three. After every form of punctuation, you need to leave a space and start the next word. For instance, there must be a space after this comma here and also here. Number four, there should not be more than one space between each word of a sentence. As you can see, there are two spaces here. These mistakes affect your score in grammar, which is one of the six enabling skills. Some don'ts. Don't practice typing in Microsoft Word, as it autocorrects your misspellings. Instead, you can type in Notepad, where it does not autocorrect your spellings. And once you are done writing your summary, copy and paste it in a Microsoft Word document to find out your typos. Why should I use a template for my summarizes in text? Firstly, when you use a template, you don't have to worry whether your answer is in one sentence or not. You just need to concentrate on finding important content words. Most of the students think that if they put several sentences together and replace all full stops with commas and semicolons, and put only one full stop at the end, they have composed one sentence. Look at this example. So here, the student has loosely connected three sentences via the connector and a comma. In the last sentence, there's not even a connector before they as the subject. It is just a comma and a subject. So technically speaking, this is more than one sentence. Secondly, if you use a template, you don't have to worry about grammatical mistakes such as subject-verb disagreement, because the structure of the template is in a way that any subject, singular or plural, you use in the blanks will not affect the subject-verb agreement of the template. Look at the following summarize it in text answer. Can you find a subject-verb disagreement? I'll give you some time to examine it.
So I want you to find a subject-verb disagreement here. So the subject is, for instance, singular and the verb is plural. So as you can see here, a rise in winter temperatures have. What's the problem here?
It should temperature has.
Very good, because the subject is a rise. And it is singular, very good. And temperature, people think that because it's temperatures plural, you have to have here. But the subject is here, a rise in winter temperatures has presented. There you go, the first is, and the computer is very good at picking up grammatical mistakes like this.
All right, in the first sentence, the subject is rise, and it is singular. Thus, the verb should be in agreement with the subject and should be singular. But as you can see here, the verb is have, and this is a grammatical mistake.
Okay, next one. Oh, we just did this one.
Why should I use a template for my summarize it in text?
Yeah, this one. Okay, and the strategies. All right.
Summarize it in text strategies. Number one, memorize the template word for word. Okay, the first thing you do is to memorize the template by typing it. You need to memorize it as it is, with all the punctuation exactly where they are. Once you memorized it, depending on your typing speed, of course, it will take around 2 minutes to type it. As you can see, the words in black need to be memorized, and the words in red need to be filled from the Summarize It in Text passage. Number two, don't try to make sense. When you fill in the blanks with content words, don't even try to make sense. The computer is good at the spelling, punctuation, and grammar, but not at semantics, which is another name for meaning of words. Watch this video to see what I mean. First, a computer does not compare essays against one another. That is why you can use the same template for your essays should you get two topics in your test. Second, a computer is best at checking your spellings, grammar, and punctuation. But when it comes to semantics, which is another name for words, meaning, and logic, computers fail. Let me give you an example to clarify this. Imagine your essay topic is about shopping with credit cards, and you write the following sentences as an example for developing your idea one. For instance, my cat Sheba loves spending with my credit card. She does all my errands early in the morning before I wake up. Then she drives my dog to a business district near my house for a morning window shopping. So once the computer software analyzes this section, it finds all the spellings, grammar, and punctuation in order. Then the software finds the following words: spending, credit card, do errands, business district, and window shopping, highly related to the main theme of the essay topic, which is shopping. Therefore, the software gives a high score to the essay's content and vocabulary. What the computer has totally missed out, and only a human examiner could pick on, is the fact that cats cannot do any of the above activities. So the moral of the story is that so long as the grammar, spellings, and punctuation of your essay are okay, you do not need to necessarily make sense in your sentences. Number three, choose the most important content words. Read the passage and try to find out the main idea of the text. Then try to fill in the blanks with the most important content words. You can find content words that are the answer to the following WH questions. What, when, where, why, who, and how many. Also use any nouns, adjectives, proper nouns, and names that have been repeated several times in one of the blanks. For example, in this Summarize It in Text, the word nurse shark has been repeated more than 6 times. You can choose up to 5 or 6 content words in each blank. But 3 words, adjective and noun compounds, would be fine. You can also use a main verb with its accompanying words in one of the blanks, so long as the verb is in ing form. Number 4. Do not use any auxiliary verbs or helping verbs in the blanks. Auxiliary verbs such as am, is, are, and the rest, as you can see here in this list. The reason is that once you throw in a helping verb or an auxiliary verb, it messes with the grammar of the template. So no auxiliary verbs in the blanks. Number 5. Do not fill in the blanks with adverbs of time. Adverbs of time such as ago, yesterday, last year, 2 months ago, and so on. Again, the reason is that adverbs of time ruin the grammar of the template. So no adverbs of time either. Number 6. Use a main verb plus ing in blank number 3. In all other blanks, you can use nouns and adjectives and even main verbs, so long as they are in ing form or gerund. But in blank number 3, you specifically need to use a main verb from the content and make it into ing form. This is because of the grammatical structure of that part of the sentence. We use a verb in ing form after a preposition, and 2 here is a preposition. Number 7. You don't need to fully understand the passage. If reading is not your forte, just fill in the 11 blanks with adjectives and nouns and a verb in ing form in blank number 3. You will get a reasonable score for this section. But I would certainly suggest that you read the passage and choose the main content words for the blanks, nouns and...
If you like, take a photo of this because these are what you need to pay attention to, these 5 points, okay? Simon, did you take a photo? Okay, all right, good. All right, any questions up to now? No questions? All right, fantastic.
You shouldn't use the...
Yes, he told me, please.
Number 5, do not use any adverbs of time in the blank. Mm-hmm. Just don't mention, like,
yes,
that kind of words. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right. So, because that would, tamper with the structure. So no last month, 2 days ago, you know, that sort of thing. Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we'll start with an actual filling in the blanks with the template. So we'll start with that one. Okay.
All right. Let's do a few real PTE summarizes in text from the PTE.com practice website. Now, if you do not have an account or you want to practice on your own, you can type in Notepad because, as I said before, it does not autocorrect your misspellings. So once you open the Notepad, go to the Format tab and tick the word wrap so that it types within the visible frame. Once you typed your response to the summarize it in text within the 10-minute time frame, copy and paste your answer in the Microsoft Word and check your typos. By the way, these are the same misspellings that you are going to make again in your exam if you do not take care of them by practicing. Okay, the first thing I do is to type the template. So master the typing of the template and the content words, of course, you are typing them from the text in front of you. Okay, so I type the whole template first with the blank numbers. Then I read the summarize it in text and try to understand the main idea of the text and also look for those WH questions, what, where, when, who, and so on. I will give you some time to read the text. So as you noticed, the whole passage was about a tiny tree frog and the circumstances under which it was found. And I'm going to use a tiny tree frog in blank number one. By the way, as I said before, you do not have to make sense here, but to be organized and up to the point, I started to fill in the blanks from the top to the bottom of the text. And I could do the opposite or even randomly, and it would be still fine so long as you have all the main content words in the template. Okay. In blank number two, I use amber, and three, as you know, we need to use a verb in ing form, gerund. The verb preserve is highly related to the topic. So I throw it in blank number three in ing form. A Mexican researcher, which is the answer to who, goes to blank number four. A miner in southern Chiapas goes to number five, which is another answer for who, one of those WHs. And 25 million years goes to blank number six, which is the answer to when, another WH question, remember? Next, it is Gerardo Carbot in number seven. In blank eight, I put well-preserved DNA and frogs remains for blank number nine. And drilling a hole into the chunk for blank number 10. Remember, if you want to use a main verb in any of the blanks, it must be in ing form. So I used drill in ing form to make it into a noun phrase and therefore compatible with the grammar of our template. And finally, in gap number 11, I use species. By the way, if you need to throw in more content words, you can add more after blank number 10, by adding a comma and then the content words, as long as you do not cross the word limit of 75 words. All right, let's start.
Up to now, any questions?
Is the frog's remains noun or?
I'm sorry?
There was a blank filled with frog's remains.
Yes.
Is there
a noun? Remains is a noun. Remains means whatever remained from now, from that. Remains means body. Okay? Remains
is what?
Is body.
Body.
Yes, what is left from body? So, for instance, if somebody is dead, we say his remains means whatever remained from his body. Okay.
I got it. Okay, understand.
Good. Yeah.
And also, is it okay to fill that blank with that, like 25 million years? Like you said, we shouldn't mention like.
Yeah. Very good, but yeah. this doesn't mean go. This doesn't mean a go. So okay. I told you the ago last month, last year, because they specifically refer to a point in time. But here it's when, 25 million years, that's when. Okay. So you need that one. It's time, when. All right. But not last month, for instance, or, you know, a word that specifically refers to a point in time that takes the whole sentence into a different dimension. Yes.
So for instance, 2020 or 1945 is okay to fill the
Of course. Of course. These are dates. You can. But not specifically not ago and last month. Okay.
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions? Alicia, any questions? No? Okay. Good. All right. If you don't have any questions, Pradipa, any questions? No? Good. So, do you want one more? I have one more after this, yes? Okay. Itomi, do you want to see one more?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the rest of it is another one?
Adding a comma and then the content words, as long as you do not cross the word limit of 75 words.
Next session in the class, I'll give you summarize it in text and I'll give you 10 minutes, maybe the session after the next session. Okay, so you have at least 1 week to practice and memorize this. So you need to memorize this by typing. I know three students have already memorized it because they have already sent me the some samples and they were very good. So once you memorize it, you can send straight to me via WhatsApp. But here in the class, I want to make sure that you have memorized it and we practice it, okay?
All right, let's do another one. And as usual, first you type the template and I'm going to fast forward the video. Otherwise, I cannot type this fast, but practice makes perfect, you know that. Okay, I give you some time to read the text. Okie dokie. As you all noticed, the text was about three main reasons why American English has become the most influential variety of English in the world today. So we try to fill in the blanks with those content words that directly express these three reasons. So I use American English in blank number one, and the most influential variety of English in blank number two. For blank number three, as you are all aware by now, we use a main verb in gerund, and the word influence is a common theme here, so I use it in ing form, influencing in blank number three. In blank number four, I throw in the most powerful nation, and in blank five, I use a dialect with an army. In blank six, I am going to use America's political influence, and I have used the word influence for the second time, which doesn't matter, even if both were of the same part of speech. Anyway, in blank number seven, popular culture will be a good choice, as it is one of the three main reasons for America's linguistic dominance in the world. In blank number eight, I use international dominance. And for the next blank, number nine, communications technology, Microsoft fills the gap, number 10. And for the last blank, number 11, I use a default setting for language. So there you are. We have used the most important content words related to the theme of the text in one single sentence.
All right. Now, any questions? No, no questions? Yes, he told me.
And Bill Gates or Kahane, I don't know. Mm-hmm. Maybe the content words?
They are, but once you say Microsoft, it belongs to Bill Gates. Okay, so I would say Microsoft is the headline and Bill Gates is under.
Okay.
Because gotcha. They are, yes.
Okay.
But you know, it's up to you. But okay. I would tell you that above 10%, above 10-15% similarity, you're going to get the full mark. Don't worry about it.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay. No more questions? We're going to start with reading now, this time. So up to now, you have noticed that we have four sections in the test: speaking, writing, reading, and listening. Now, the most important part of writing, of course, was summarize it in text and essay writing. I would say summarize it in text gives more point than essay writing. And in reading, the first part, this one, reading and writing fill in the blanks, gives you the highest point. And number two in reading, so this is number one, is this one, reading fill in the blanks. And today we're going to start with reading fill in the blanks, okay? Now, in reading fill in the blanks, the first thing you do is you read the choices at the bottom. And once you are done, then you start reading, and the ones you're 100% sure, you try to drag in, and you know, and then if you're not sure about this one, we'll leave it for the last. But spend around 30 to 40 seconds on each question. So here, 2, 4, 6, I've got six blanks, and 6 times 4, that's 240 divided by almost 4 minutes. You can spend 4 or 5 minutes. Remember, these are the most important questions. So there aren't any more important questions than this waiting for you. So now we're gonna start with 543. Okay? So I'll give you some time and then I'll come back to you and ask you what you think is the answer. Okay, so I'm going to ask one of you, and then you're not still done, right? Some of you are still doing. Okay, keep going. Okay, who wants to give it a go? Hitomi? Are you ready? Okay, you do this one, Hitomi. Yes, you tell me. First one?
It's found. Not sure.
Okay, number two?
B?
I'm sorry, which one?
Issues.
Okay.
Yes.
And number three?
Response.
Number four?
I wanted to use found again.
Okay, you have to choose another because you've already used it there, yes.
This can be analyzed.
Okay. And?
Analysis ends there.
Very good. Yeah. Ends there.
level of individual action. Answers, I don't know.
Okay.
Answers.
Level. So the problem is that so often as is there.
Action.
Answers cannot be, okay. You want to put answers?
Mm.
Okay. Let's check. Okay. But that was very good. You got 4 correct. Mm. Now, if you pay attention to before and after each blank. So here we have is. So whenever we have is, am, is, are, and to be, basically to be before, we need to have a PP. A PP means the past participle, okay? So here we are, we have 3 past participle here, basically. 1, 2, 3. And then there was a distractor there as well, okay? So once you have this, you say, okay, it must be either located, analyzed, characterized. So now, you analyze it in terms of meaning, okay? Now, so here, the problem is often analysis ends there at the level of individual, characterized in terms of, okay. So, and here we have found, oh, these are the distractors, okay? The distractors are, I mean, you don't have it in the test, you won't get it. This is the others, of course. But the distractors are set aside. Anyway, that was very good. That was very good, okay? Because I found it very difficult. I myself found it very difficult, okay? Even though, now there's a theological question here. I want to give you a theological question. Do you know what theology is, everyone? Theology? Theology. Now is related to God, okay? So I want to give you a theology question. Now, somebody said, can God create a stone that he himself cannot lift? Can God create a stone so big that he himself cannot lift that stone? The answer is yes. Yes, because this question is made by me, and I found it very difficult to answer. So yes, there can be a stone that cannot be moved by God himself or herself. Okay, next one. Very good. Three minutes here, everyone, and then I'll ask someone to do it for me. Sorry, this S is extra. There's something wrong here. This S shouldn't be. I think this is Australia's. Okay, so that S is extra. I have to get rid of it. Oh. Yes, it is. So the stock of Australia's whatever is evolving. So I is missing there. I need to get take care of that. Okay, time's up. Alicia.
Okay. The stock of Australia's households.
Okay, so is evolving with, yes.
Is evolving with current homes having more bedrooms on average. At the same time, dwellings are getting smaller.
Mm-hmm.
Dwellings?
Yes. Sorry. Oopsie-daisy. Oopsie-daisy. I'm not listening to you. Yes. Number three.
Are getting smaller. With decreasing fractions of couple families.
And the last one?
The article examines.
Very good. Anyone has a different idea?
First one is dwellings.
Mm-hmm. First, yeah. First yes. one so is I dwelling.
Think, yes. Yes. And these two, you should.
Yeah. Households.
Yes. At the same time, households are getting. Yes.
Smaller. But
you see, yes. Let's just check. I have the same suspicion. Oh. Okay. So the stock of Australia's dwelling. Very good. Households. And decreasing proportions. You wanted to say this, Pradeepa, right? You want to say proportions.
Proportions, that's
very good. Very good. There you go. There you go. So you see, in the exam, it wouldn't be this difficult, Alicia. Okay, it wouldn't be this difficult. Mine, thank goodness I didn't come up with the questions in the PTE exam, but these are very difficult. But once you get used to this, the exam would be very easy for us. I mean, students, when they do this, it's like, oh, the exam was very easy. Is this all like that? But, okay. Very good. So this, just you made this mistake of households and dwelling. So dwelling refers to a house, and household refers to things inside a house. That's households, okay? Next one. So first read the choices. Mayuko, are you ready for this one? Whenever you're ready, if you are.
Noticed.
So very good. The first one, you need a PP, okay? Because it's have you done, have you gone? So it should be PP. And we've got bothered, occupied, and attended. So very good. Out of these three, the best is attended. Very good. You attend the school. Number two. Oh, you can't be bothered answering this, right?
You just can't be.
Mayuko, you can't bother. You can't be bothered answering this question, right?
Yeah, bothered.
Yes. It's a very common collocation. Oh, I can't be bothered. You know, I can't be bothered. That's a very dismissal, common way of dismissing something. You know, I can't be bothered. Okay. Number three.
That particular.
So for this one, watch my YouTube video on this. That lesson. So on one side, on the other side, you have a noun. So you need an adjective here. And we have special and particular. So one is answer, the other one is a distractor. Very good. Number four.
Attitude.
Very good. Which one? This one or this one?
Last one.
This one. What does this one mean?
Attitude is attitude.
Height. It's height. Yeah. Okay. It's height, altitude. And number five?
If you try to read me, you're tired. Sorry.
No?
Occupied.
Very good. Why? Because of with. Okay. I'm occupied with cutting the grass. I was occupied with cutting the grass. With is the preposition here. Very good. Occupied with something. And you are always seem to be occupied with your cat most of the time, right? Okay. And the last one.
If you make no problem, just.
Now, Mayuko,
yeah.
You need a verb here. You need a verb here in the simple form, yeah. Okay? Which one is a verb?
Last one.
Very good. So you see, you cannot put noticed here, okay? You didn't put notice here? Did you ask me to do notice and I put attended for you?
No, I said the first one is noticed.
Yeah.
Sorry, because yes, I just noticed that notice should be up there. I'm not listening to you. I am not. I am a very naughty teacher tonight. I don't know why. So have you noticed? Very good. So here you need a verb in simplest form, and that is slip, even though you don't know what it means. Okay, you need to go for that. And this special is not a verb. This is not a verb. This is a verb, but in PP format, so it's not good. There you go. So grammar here helps you. Grammar helps you, all right? So I particularly ask you to watch that YouTube of mine about, do you want me to send the link to you right now? Okay, I'll send the link to you right now.
It's the video.
Yes, please, yeah.
Yes, right, reading fill in the blanks, okay? Here is so dark, I cannot see the keyboard. Can you believe me? And Simon is not here to turn the light. I mean, he doesn't want to turn. Huh? Okay, yes, so. Here it is. I've got two, this is the best one. And then you can check the other one as well. But this is the best one. I have explained everything there. So I just...
Hello, this is Hugh, and I'm one of the PT trainers.
Okay, so I'll send it through the chat for everyone. There you go. Now, I think... do you want to do one more? Yes. Yeah, okay, let's go. So today we don't do any, tonight we don't do any speaking. First is the choices. So Pradeepa, you get ready whenever it's your time. Whenever you're ready, just let us know. Oh, Pradeepa, you did one, right? Didn't you? Did you do one? No, okay. So whenever you're ready.
First one is participation.
Very good.
And the second. Recognition.
Okay. So increasing ing is a sign of adjective. So you need a noun. T-I-O-N is always a sign of a noun. T-I-O-N and T-Y. So these two are the nouns here. So between these two, you're going with this one. Okay. The third one.
Having family. The family ranging from income provider.
Ranging. Yes, ranging. That's all right. And the last one?
Therefore, balancing paycheck.
Yes. Okay. Anyone else has a different idea?
I think, the ranging, rather than ranging, it's...
Starting.
Yeah, starting.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And recognition, rather than increasing recognition, rather than activity.
Increasing.
There has activity. Been increasing. Recognition, right?
Recognition is correct. Yes.
Yep.
Okay. Let's see whether it's starting or ranging. Okay. I personally think that starting, because it says from
income,
because the first job, the first role of a father is income provider, so that's I think ranging from. Now why not starting is not the answer, because we say starting with, we don't say starting from. Okay, starting with income provider. And then, so we don't have with, we have from. And the preposition for range is from. So the age of the student in my class ranges from 15 to 50. Okay? 50 is Simon and 15 is me. All right, just to let you know the the range, the real range. Okay, I'm 15. Remember, Simon, I'm 15, 15, and you are the opposite, 51, 51, okay? You take it? Do you take it? I absolutely take it, okay? I absolutely take it. All right, next one, Simon, it's your turn. Okay, let's go for the next one. So first read the... Oh, it's a biggie. Okay, this one is good.
Majority of US high school students say they get majority of US high school students say they get security and that dropping off according to survey. The survey of 81,000 students in 26 states. States. Exactly.
Simon, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
The first one is baller.
See, which one? The third or?
The third one.
The third one.
Yeah.
Okay.
And release.
Very good, released. Number three.
Found.
Excellent. Number four, Simon.
Boredom.
Very good. Because you need a noun, okay? You need a noun here because complain of something. So whenever you have of, after of, it is a noun, for instance. The city of whatever, it's a noun, okay? So D-O-M is a sign of making a noun. So for instance, United Kingdom, okay? Boredom, what else is them? okay, so D-O-M is a sign of a noun. Let's check. Anyone thinks differently?
The second one can be conducted.
A survey, okay. According to a survey conducted on Wednesday, a survey can be conducted, okay? But the results, if you see the results, it's released. Let's just check, very good. Yes, it is released because we say, we usually use the time of release rather than a survey conducted in the United States, okay? That was a very naughty distractor that I used, conducted, okay? I used that particular, I myself didn't fall for it, but I thought that it's it would be, yeah, an eye catcher.
Okay, sorry, why was it released?
Because of the date. Because of the date on Wednesday. Okay. Now we usually say a survey was conducted in America. Okay, we do not use a particular date for the conduction of that ceremony.
Because it cannot be finished on one day.
Very good, excellent. Because you take it, then you analyze it, you know.
But yeah, that's right.
Can be. But as I said, it was a very tricky one. Very tricky. Okay. And the last one. Very good. And the last one. I think everyone did, but your guitar. Yes. So this time it's yours. So take your time and whenever you're ready. So, Yagita, whenever you're ready. You need to, whenever you're ready, you need to unmute yourself.
Yep. The gallery's conservation department performs one of the gallery's core function, the long term preservation of all collection items to make them accessible.
Accessible, very good.
I think accessible now and in future. The
from
collection good, dates.
Very from good.
Dates
from. Very good.
Dates, the collection dates from the 8th century.
Preposition from, yes. And
consists of portraits in a variety of media. So the gallery, I think, employs range of acts, including framing, painting, paper, sculpture, and photography.
Okay, very good. Anyone has a different idea about any of these blanks? Tell me.
Can be disciplines.
Which one? Very good. Yes, the last one.
Range of disciplines.
That's a discipline. Very good. So framing, painting,
yeah,
paper.
Discipline.
Yes, yes, discipline. Very good.
But number one, I wasn't sure acts or perform.
Gallery.
The collocation.
For act, you say acts as, we say acts as one of the great. So the preposition as is missing here. That's why you cannot use as. But very good. Yeah. Act as one of them. So the collocation. I always say that pay attention to the preposition. Now, the preposition can be immediately after the blank or it can be 3 kilometers away, for instance. somewhere around
the long
here.
Term.
Yes.
Yeah.
For instance, as could be here, as. And then you say, oh, acts, okay, acts as. So, but here, immediately, we should have as. So, excellent. Dug it up, very good. Now, most students have problems in reading. So for instance, speaking is fine, but reading is one of the challenging. Now, I think your reading is good, but you can make sure by practicing more, okay? If you practice, I've got 600 pages of these questions, and they are all exam questions or similar to exam, and some of them are real exam questions, okay? Don't ask me how I got them. Okay, you are asking. I know you are asking, okay? In China, the questions somehow leaked out. Now, the question didn't leak out in this form. They leaked out in the form of a PDF that has all the articles that made questions. So what I did, but I have all those articles, and for those articles, I made questions. So we are sure that these are articles from the test centers, okay, PT test centers, and there are a lot of them. That's why when it happened, they closed down that particular test center, but still they are using these articles in different forms. Now, one of my students came to me and I had a read aloud, and she said, blah, 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 blah. Oh my goodness, this was my exam question in fill in the blanks, reading fill in the blanks. So what they do is that they use the same articles in different test items. So for instance, read aloud goes to fill in the blanks goes to the read aloud, you know, that sort of things. But I think by now they must have changed most of their questions. But I haven't sat the test yet myself in probably 2 years now. I'm going to sit the test one of these months to check what the types of questions, and it's particularly the reading section, and see if they have new questions or not, because I have read all the questions, but now I'm reading it, I can't remember that I have made this, because there are a lot of them. But if I sit the test, I see one, I know that whether it is still from, they are using those, or they're using new articles. Okay, any questions?
Can we go back to number 543?
I beg your pardon?
Can we go back to question number 543?
Okay, this one? Yeah.
Yeah, I made a mistake for the first blank and the last one, and I wasn't sure the reason why. Uh-huh. So it was located and...
Okay, the narrative of law and order is fundamentally at the level. So we say something is... So, the word at here is a giveaway. So we say, for instance, honesty is at the heart of friendship. So we can say honesty is located. So the word locate. And the other one was the last one?
Last one, yeah.
Okay.
Characterized.
Yes. A problem is characterized. We say this problem is characterized in terms of this and that. And here is okay, so if you make sentences simple, you can understand what it means. Okay, once they are spread out, it's difficult to say. Okay, try to minimize and shorten the sentence. Okay,
thank you.
All right, thank you very much. I'll see you. Is that tomorrow night? Do we have class tomorrow night? Wednesday? Yes. Okay, I'll be on Wednesday. Have a good one. See ya.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.